Oh, man, that is heavy. A winch at the front and the PTO at the back. All I need to do now is join the two up. So to stabilize that area, I'm gonna introduce a rose joint. I'm gonna put it on the back piece here, then mount the UJ to join them together, and then somehow fix that rose joint firmly to the chassis. Bracket on. Like so. And then I've got a really nice obvious place to weld it because that chassis cross member is flat. Before I can weld to there, I am going to need to clean it up. Now is the moment of truth. Now if I engage my PTO, place it in gear, I'm going for first gear. See, now my engine should be driving my makeshift drive shaft, powering my winch. The truck's drive shaft is now disengaged. Then the PTO drive shaft is engaged. There you go. I can see that UJ's turning nicely. It's being powered by the prop shaft I've made from the PTO. And the winch, well, it's doing the job of a winch. In fact, if I... See, now I've turned the winch off, but the PTO's still powering. Marvellous! See, this is why I love Land Rover so much. I mean, think about it. This winch is being powered, not by electrics, but by a 2.25-litre diesel engine. It's no longer a car. It's now a mobile piece of equipment. It's a tool. And that is why Land Rover leaves such a lasting legacy.
Click here to subscribe.